Hello, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel, click on the bell, like and comment.
Okumbro na metuahu mala chano na ye krabe heno ati apose ti no me moway na dum autofix e yuduma ko bia enam omoso ama mala chano abeye shemu akura medwen ho amente ase na se dwuma obo ho de enya dwuma ketwa jai waye alignment and balancing car suspension polishing and detailing steam wash na se base yenye interior decoration pa wo sen mu a kokumtum da jai o se san oil san siesie wo sen no ma edimu afese wa fidie no emu odu chen asono aduonum kura obemma so siesie ama pepepepepepe obehu nadum autofix e o dansoman asoy da ho woni kfc ene di nhwani mu fre nadum autofix e o nwoma iso 0244 733 249 0246 519 369 nadum autofix wo sen no betija.
My name is Patrick Obis, the lead pastor of West Presbyterian Church in Kumasi. By the grace of God, I have a question that I would like to present to all of you. The first one is, yes, I don't know the situation where you are, but in the moment, like, I'm just according to the books that can encourage you to move from where you are to another level. Then, what am I on earth for? You need to discover the reason why God has placed you on the earth. Then, inside Noah's ark, you just love this book. Noah we know in the ark. He linked the ark with different species together with his immediate family. So discover how Noah was able to lead all these people with different traits. If you read this book, your life will never ever be the same again. God bless you.
So when the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of Jesus, the mother of James, and Salome, brought spices so that they might go and anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, I'm reading from the NIV. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb? Verse 4. But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. Verse 6. Don't be alarmed, he said. You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
He is not here. See the place where they laid him. Verse 7. But go. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But go. Tell his disciples and Peter. But go, tell his disciples and Peter. He is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you. Amen.
Amen.
May the entrance of the word bring life,
Amen.
Revival, renewal, refreshment unto your people.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Mark chapter 16 is an interesting chapter in the Bible. Verse 1 says that when the Sabbath was over, it is not a passage that is normally preached on a gospel Sunday. But I pray that this morning you have some small patience for me. And let's hear the word what God has for us as a church and as individuals. When the Sabbath was over, when Jesus had been killed on the Friday, and he had been moved into the tomb, the Sabbath ends in the evening of the Saturday. When the Sabbath was over, these three women, I pray that in our life we will always have these loyal women, the women I call loyal women. They were not so prominent in the 3-year ministry of Jesus Christ, but they were loyal.
Amen.
They were loyal.
Amen.
When the disciples were thinking about the trauma they had gone through, in fact, the hope and the expectation, they knew that Jesus was coming to save Israel. The kingship and the government of Israel, Jesus was coming to rule. The Romans were just maltreating them. And so they saw that Jesus, what he was talking about, he was also coming to save them also. Jesus did not just die. They shamed him. Their master, their leader, their hope, their confidence was put to shame. And he died. They were confused. I believe that they were not in the right state of mind, and we will see it in this scripture. But the women, these three loyal women, when the Sabbath was over, they began to look for spices so that they will go and anoint the body of Jesus Christ. In the East, in the Jewish custom, they do not anoint so that they will preserve the body. They anoint the body so that they will not smell. This morning, whatever hope, faith and confidence that you have, that is lost and has been bent and is about smelling. There is an invitation this morning for all of us in the name of Jesus. I pray that we will take it up to this invitation. We will listen to this invitation. We will answer this call. Hallelujah. These women came out and they began to look for spices. And at the break of dawn, they took a step of faith and they wanted to go. My Jesus, my hope, my confidence is dead. But you know what? He has been put to shame. So that he will not smell. Those who might have seen him die, that's shameful yet. Let's go and anoint the body of Jesus so that the body will not smell. It will not decompose and smell. They were just going to manage the smell that will come out of the body of Jesus. I don't know the state you are in now. Whoever is listening to me, wherever you are, I don't know what has happened to your faith. I don't know what has happened to your confidence. I don't know what promise that you received and where the promise has been buried. I came with an invitation to you that Jesus is still alive. Hallelujah. These two men went, and that was, you know, the most important thing that they were supposed to think about was the stone that was blocking the entrance of the tomb. They didn't think about that one, brother. They didn't think about how they would move the stone. They gathered the spices that will cover Jesus Christ. Okay, we should get people around you who will cover your sin. We should get people around you who will be able to just come along and anoint you and protect you and shield you. Hallelujah. I pray that we'll have women like Mary Magdalene, Mary Mother of James, Solomon, will be around. Sometimes they are not the loudest. You don't see them. Magdalene, we heard about her when Jesus cast the demons out of her. And that's all. We don't hear about her. We heard about her again on the cross of Calvary. standing there looking at Jesus. But these were loyal men, men are strong men, the ones that are eating with the man, that have stayed with the man, that have listened at the feet of Jesus, were confused and rationalizing and trying to understand what has gone on. These women wanted to just go and anoint the body of Jesus so that he will not swell.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hello, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel, click on the bell, like and comment.
Then they started, after they have gathered the spices, on their way going, then they remember that there was something that was heavier and now it's bigger. Then they should have thought about it. How are we going to roll this stone away? How? They began to think about it. They began to meditate about it. They began to think about how this stone will be rolled. And the Bible says that the stone was very, very large. Look and see. Oh, it is look and leave. Look and leave. My brother, look and leave. Look to Jesus and leave. Verse 4 says that, but when they looked up, the stone had already been rolled away. I pray in the name of Jesus. Any stone that is written in anybody from a certain invitation being thrown onto all of us today, I pray that the stone of hindrance be rolled away. In the name of Jesus Christ. If that stone be either be your heart, a heart that has been hardened as a stone, I pray in the name of Jesus that as you hearken unto the invitation of Jesus Christ, you receive the heart of flesh. In the name of Jesus. If there be any evidence and hindrance, I pray in the name of Jesus that it will be moved away. Though you will be able to answer to the call, answer to the invitation of Jesus. That stone had already been rolled away. He said, when they looked at her, Bible said that I will look up onto the hills. David said, I will look up onto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, the maker of the heavens and the earth. Sometimes, when we talk among ourselves and we discuss the issues that are going on around us, we'll get discouraged. In fact, it will discourage us more. It will confuse us more. It will put us down. But if we lift up our eyes, provision has already been made. He has rolled the stones away. In the name of Jesus. The stones had already been rolled away. And that stone was not rolled for Jesus to come out of the grave. Bible said that when Jesus resurrected, his resurrected body was not hindered by any material obstacle. So the disciples could be in the room and a man can appear and disappear just like that. So it wasn't for Jesus. It wasn't so that Jesus would come out of the tomb. It was so that you and I will be able to have access into the room, into the tomb, and see that the Jesus that was laid there, that was presented there lifeless, that Jesus is alive. He is risen. He is no more dead. Hallelujah. The stone was rolled away for you and I. That stone was true for you and I. If you are hearing me, if you are listening to me, whatever state that you are in, it doesn't matter what you have done, it doesn't matter where you are going, it doesn't matter your state, Jesus Christ is risen. He came because of you. He is risen. He is alive. There is nothing that is too, you have done that is too hard that Jesus cannot see. That Jesus has not dealt with. Even death, he conquered it. Amen. For you and I. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I think about this every day and it gives me a kick in my teeth. When we go to Odoku, that place, the way the women were, the ladies were having their own things. You go there and you speak to them and they come back and they tell me that, you know, young men, we understand what you are doing here. What you are doing here is so fantastic. But we have enough redemption. So speak to this our children, and these children speak to them. We don't want them to live the life that we are living. We can see that there is hope and confidence somewhere. There is hope for them. But as for us, we are beyond redemption. So leave us alone. When you comfort them, then they begin to just get angry. But I came to tell you today that Jesus has thrown an open invitation to us all in the name of Jesus Christ. If only we will hearken unto this call, if only we will answer this call, He is ready to accept us, He is ready to revive us, He is ready to write a new chapter. As the women were walking around and going to the temple, they thought that that was the end of their faith, that was the end of the promise that they had been given unto them. In fact, that was the end of the story. They didn't know that the chapter had ended, but a new chapter was about to begin. It was a new chapter that was about to begin. I would say that everybody that comes unto Jesus, if you hearken unto the call this morning, anything that you have done, your life will be turned around. A new life will begin to come forth out of you in the name of Jesus. Because the one who has given an invitation is a skillful writer. He is able to write a new chapter. Hallelujah!
Amen.
You might have seen the end of the story. The end of the story, you might have seen it. In fact, you yourself might have concluded that this story is over. I agree. I mean, I'm about getting up, living this place. But this morning I came to tell you that you should not get up now. There is a next chapter. There's a next chapter that the skillful writer is writing. Hallelujah. For you who have not accepted Jesus Christ, who have not seen Him, you think that the wrongdoing in your life, you can just cover it with money and with all kinds of things that you will do. But you need Jesus. It is only Jesus that can fill the wrongdoing that you have in your soul. And it's only Jesus that can save. And it's only Jesus. You will tell me that, well, this scripture, well, this thing that you're talking about, well, I know Jesus. I have come to Jesus. I understand this Jesus. What has it to do with me this morning? Bible said that when the angel, when the young man that the women met in the temple, I have turned it away. I say that he makes one announcement to them. He told them that this Jesus, he said, Jesus of Nazareth, we have come to see Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. The crucifixion is not a good title, it's a shameful title. And he was crucified naked on the cross. That Jesus that you came to see, is a, the crucifixion is a title that is not acceptable, and that is not nice. But in that crucifixion, in that title, that the heavens were able to just declare, I mean the angel declared it to the women. That title, in that title, is where I am found in the story of Jesus. In that crucifixion is where you and I are found in the story of Jesus. So Jesus pride himself with that title. It is shameful, alright, but he pride himself in it, because in that crucifixion, they see you like mother. He sees progress are there with all the things around. He sees all the handwriting of ordinances against my life. Anything, any judgment that was against my life, he took it and he dealt with it on that crucifixion, on that cross. He dealt with it and he used his blood to just cancel it and began to write a new chapter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's writing a new chapter. He's writing a new chapter. So Jesus is excited to be called Jesus of Nazareth, the one who was crucified. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That crucifixion was done to bring fear into their hearts, strike fear into the hearts of the disciples, and just scatter the gospel. End it all. But hallelujah.
Amen.
Hello, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel, click on the bell, like and comment.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified, Jesus of Nazareth, who was Lucifer. You have come to see this Jesus. Don't be alarmed. We are looking for him. He is risen. The angel told them that they brought a dead Jesus. He was dead. His lifeless body was brought into this tomb, but he is not here anymore. He is risen. He is alive. He is living. I gave the title of my message. In fact, I have, is that you have a living friend. Hallelujah. A living friend. We have a living friend. When the women, he said, look, I buy the blessing. When the women look, in fact, it is possible that with my sanctified mind, it is possible that when the women entered and they were so frightened, they were focused and they were fixed. They had their eyes fixed on a man who was talking to them. I believe that some of them would just be looking and saying, what is it, Jesus? Is it that it is him or not? But the man, when the angel spoke, he said, look. After listening to what I've said, that the Jesus of Nazareth was crucified, he's risen. Don't just listen to my words. Just look at where he was placed. Look at where you led him. Look at this place and see that he is not there. There's a similarity to the story of the Samaritan woman. When he had gone to Samaria to say that I have met the Messiah at the well. I went to fetch water. But yet, I have seen the living water. And when the town moved to the place, and they went and listened to Jesus, they came back and said, that woman, we have believed you, not only because of what you said, but because we ourselves, we have heard and we have seen the Messiah. Sometimes it is important to hear, but you know what? We need a firm assurance that indeed he is risen. We see. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look and live. My brother, live. Look to Jesus and live. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The tomb is empty because of human power. We were not around to see the miracles of Jesus. We were not around to see him physically. But that the tomb is empty for us to know that indeed our friend, he is a living friend. It's good to have friends. It's good to have friends. But sometimes you get into situations, you pick a phone, you want to call your friend, and the network is jammed. If the network is not jammed, it goes and it's not able to pick it up. But we have a living friend who is not limited by human and material obstacles. He is able to appear and disappear just like that. He is sitting by the phone. All he's waiting for is that you will just make a call and say that Jesus, the invitation that you drew, is it still around for me? Am I too late or I can still come for? Is that invitation still ready? He is ready.
Amen.
And he will tell you that that invitation is still ready and it's still available for you. You and I. Hallelujah. Anybody that will just call, answer that invitation that I've been thrown. Jesus is ready to accept you. Jesus is ready to give you a new life. Jesus is ready to begin to write a new chapter. Begin a new chapter in your life. Hallelujah. He's alive. Our living friend is alive. He is living and he's alive. I want to jump. I want to run. And just come to what I want to really talk about. Verse 7. It says that, but go. The angel was talking to them about Jesus, telling them the state in which Jesus was brought, lifeless, the man who was life. I mean, the giver of life, brought and presented in the place, lifeless. And that he was risen, he said. And he had told them, invited them to look at where they placed him. Now he spoke to them. He gave them the reason why he was there, the reason why he was sent there. He was seated. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, whatever we are going through, I pray that Jesus, we will find Jesus sitting and sitting on our knees. Hallelujah. May angels begin to minister to you at your place, the place where your promise is buried, a place where your hope is crushed. May ministration begin to come out of that very place in the name of Jesus. He said that, but go, but go. Go tell the disciples and Peter. What is this? I thought Peter was one of the disciples. And he was one of the first who was called. He said, go and tell the disciples and Peter. This morning, I came to say, to give an invitation to PIWC. go tell PIWC and the pastor. Go and tell them. Go and tell PIWC and the people in the church. Go and tell them. Go and tell them that Jesus has gone ahead of them. Hallelujah. You see, sometimes it is easy. It is easy to come in. It is easy to preach this message outside. And very difficult to preach it in. We make it so difficult to preach the same message inside. But we are people in who have issues. We need to respond to the call. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need to respond to the call. Jesus resurrected. And the first thing on the mind of Jesus was to show mercy and to show grace to the people he worked with who had denied him. At the point, Thomas said that, well, let us go. Let us go with our master so that we may go and die with him. But when the master was dying, Thomas was going. I have not seen in the pages of this scripture where Thomas was standing on the cross of Golgotha, on the hill of Golgotha. Thomas was nowhere. Jesus has shared this. He has shared this ministry, his life with this three, and he has disappointed. Sometimes we have taken to the first call. They're called to come in. People have come all right. And issues, pressures of life, and life sometimes throw us from us. It hits us so well, and people begin to sit down and think that is this thing so real? I mean, am I bad? Am I really, really saved? How am I getting such happiness? Where is the defense that heaven promised me? I came to tell you this morning, there is an invitation for you. Jesus says that come, and he will reveal himself unto you one more time. Hallelujah. He said, go tell the disciples and Peter. Some studies say that Peter, he mentioned Peter because Peter was the first person of the disciples. Others also say that he mentioned the name of Peter because Peter was at that time, he was not with the disciples. He had yet deserted the disciples and was on his way somewhere. Others also say, and I want to associate myself with a third point, that Peter had denied Jesus, and so he was finding it difficult to restore himself and to believe that he is part. Jesus can accept him. Peter, the one through whom the revelation of the Christ came, and Jesus said that upon this revelation, the church will be built, and the gates of hell cannot resist it. That person who had that revelation now is confused. He's sliding and backsliding and downsliding. But hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank God for a living friend, Jesus. That he will not just leave his somewhere else, and you are not even moving. You are like breakfast and standing, I came to tell you, through an invitation to you, that it doesn't matter what life has happened to you. It doesn't matter what life has done unto you. Jesus is throwing an invitation to you that come and he will restore you. Come in the pain that you are in. Come in the oppression that you are in. Come in the infirmity that is in your body that is causing you to faint. Come. He called you all come. Let us all come unto him so that he will reveal himself one more time unto us. I will say that he is the author and the perfecter of our faith. He starts it and he ends it in us. In the process, in a midway, he is working. On a Saturday, the Sabbath is a day that they don't do anything. Everybody thought that Jesus was not doing anything. But on the Sabbath, scripture says that he went into Hades and he preached the gospel there. And so, sometimes when you are not seeing anything, when there is so much calm, relax. That is the calm before the storm. He is moving. He is working. Hallelujah. Don't be on our feet. As many that have worried, they are blessed, confused. In fact, life might have happened to you, and you begin to think, am I still part of this group? Am I part of the disciples? Jesus is calling the disciples, and he's calling you, Peter. He's calling you. The Peter, just put your name there. He's calling you personally. Just come for restoration. Come and let me reveal this myself one more time unto you. May we begin to pray in the name of Jesus.
Sinti di mi 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 di m the Lord in prayer. Do nothing this man forsaking. Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his own kingdom there shall be. Thou wilt find a solid land. What a friend we have in Jesus. Is a grief to bear. What a privilege to carry. And return to God in prayer. Oh, what be free of the fathers. Oh, what needless baby bear. Oh, because we do not care.
Just satisfy that, and you can't get any substitute for Jesus. I want to just throw an invitation unto you. Come to Jesus. If you are ready to accept Jesus as your Lord and your personal Savior, I want to leave you this morning. You want to accept Jesus into your life as your Lord and your personal Savior. You want to say that, Lord Jesus. Wherever you are, you want to say, Lord Jesus, I thank you for my life. I thank you for your work on the cross. I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. Come and live in me. Be my Lord and my Savior. Lead me through this life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
My name is Patrick, the lead pastor West Presbyterian Church in Kumasi. By the grace of God, I have a question to the light to provide to all of you. The first one is, yes, we have been entitled to the situation you are, but in the presence, like I just read the books, that have carried you to from where you are to another level. Then, what am I on earth for? You need to discover the reason why God has placed you on the earth. Then, inside knowest us. You just love this book. No one will know in the heart. He linked in the heart of different species together with his immediate family. So, discover how Noah was able to lead all these people with different traits. If you read this book, your life will never ever be the same. God bless you.
Hello, welcome to Natum Auto Fix Center, your one-stop center for auto cleaning and servicing. We have well-trained, experienced and dedicated staff to get your job done in no time. Come with me for a quick tour. At Natum Auto Fix Center, we have two departments, the cleaning department and the servicing department. The cleaning department undertakes the following: car washing. Here, we use the state-of-the-art 21st century technology like the foam spraying machine and hydraulic car lifter to give you a perfect finish. The foam machine contains chemicals which protect the paint of your car from fading, whilst the hydraulic car lifter helps to clean the under of your car thoroughly. Car detailing. Here, we use the latest technology to clean every dust and dirt from your car. We also brighten both the interior and exterior of your headlights for your car to look like a brand new car. Steam engine wash. This is the latest technology used to clean car engines to avoid water leaking into the engine. We also make dusty engines look like a brand new engine. Now, let's go to the servicing department. Here, we undertake routine servicing and maintenance of all cars and trucks. We have 21st century state-of-the-art technology to service and diagnose all kinds of cars. Our services include tire servicing, balancing, alignment settings, suspension works, disc settings, oil change, brakes, general diagnosis. We are proud to say that we are the only servicing company that has the latest machines and technology in the country. We have a 20,000 kilogram lifter, which can lift the heaviest car in this country, like tipper trucks, articulators, Costa buses, and others. We can also arrange to pick your car to service if you have a busy schedule. We are inviting individuals and corporate organizations, both private and government, to come work with us for your routine servicing and maintenance. We work 24/7, so you can drive in at any time of the day. We are located in Accra at Dansuman, Asoridahun, opposite KFC on the Hansonic Road. Call us on 0246-519-369. Natum Auto Fix Center. From cleaning to servicing, we are the best.